Hey everybody, this is Nick, and welcome to our lesson number 9, and I think our final lesson in our mini-series on how to make a visual infographic right inside of PowerPoint. Thank you again to the Visual Capitalist over on Instagram. We're using their design as an example to see if we can remake their design that they posted on Instagram right inside of PowerPoint. So I'm going to link to them above and below. They do great data viz, and I hope that you go and subscribe to their page. Now in this final lesson, we're going to work with the bar chart. In lesson number 8, we created the beautiful background here on the gradient-filled bar chart, but now we're going to do a few little things for the labels that we see here. So when I look at this, I see the ranking 1 through 10, these gradient labels right here on the end of each bar. We have the bar labels here that are the city names, and then we have the data labels here on the inside of the bars. So we're going to go ahead and escape out of this slide, and I'm just going to talk through how I thought about some of this stuff. Now, some of these things are going to be kind of easy and brute force. So the first one I just want to say is that for our purposes, we're going to go ahead and just add text boxes to the inside of these bars once we're finished with this. So that's going to be just a brute force. We know how to insert a text box, and I just turned the text white. Make sure that you're going to use your alignment tools to align everything, all those text boxes to the left, and distribute them evenly. So we're going to do that on the arrange tools menus. Make sure you use your alignment tool, align left and distribute vertically when we do that. Okay, so I just wanted to show you that. That's probably going to be the last thing that we add here on this slide. This is kind of where we left everything in lesson number 8, is this sort of standard bar chart. We want to make sure to put some data labels in each of these bars. So to do that on a live chart, I'm going to right click the series of bars, and then we're going to add data labels. So add those data labels here. You can see they default to the center usually when we have a stacked bar chart like this. So we're going to first I want to update the font. I want to make sure that we're using that nice Bandrift medium condensed. I'm going to go ahead and increase the font size maybe to 12 or 14. And now instead of the middle, I want them to be on the end. So what we're going to do, that format data labels menu has probably popped up here. We're going to click on the bar chart icon right there. And under label position, instead of center, we're going to say inside end. That moves the labels to the end of the bars. Now the number, under number, you can see that there's no dollar signs here or values for these numbers. So under number, I'm going to click that. Under category, instead of general, we're going to go ahead and say currency. And that gives us those dollar signs. It also gives us a decimal place, two decimal places to default, but I don't need those. So I'm going to go ahead and push 0 and then enter. And now we have our nice data labels. Now the thing is, we will get rid of these labels. Those are the built-in y-axis labels for our bar. So I can, at this point, I think I can just go ahead and backspace to delete that altogether. We don't need it. And now what I want to do is I want to add, what I'm thinking about adding these numbers, these ranking numbers 1 through 10 to my list. Now, if I wanted to, I could just go ahead and brute force add those in text boxes too. But I wanted to show you a little trick that I learned from Carlos Barboza, and he has a wonderful YouTube channel called Spilled Graphics. I hope you go and check that out. I'll link to him below. But he had a great post on how to sort of align, work with different alignments, either left alignments, right alignments in bar chart labels. It's not easy in Excel to left align them or right align them. So he came up with this little hack. And so this is a stacked bar chart. What we're going to do is essentially add another stack below the 0 point. So we're going to add a stack, maybe let's just say a series of maybe all the way to negative 500. So in order to make this a little bit easier, I want to bring back my x-axis. So let's go ahead under this little Skittle menu, that little plus sign here, click on that, and then we're going to say we want our primary horizontal axis. So where is that? There it goes. It comes back. You might have to check it and uncheck it. But you can see right now it goes from 0 to negative, or 0 to 5,000. Let's go ahead, and I'm going to push the little plus sign to get rid of those menus. Let's go to that bar chart menu, and instead of 0, let's make our minimum negative 500. And I'm going to go ahead and do that. And when we do that, we get this weird little kind of area right here. That's because we don't have a series yet in our bar chart. But what we're going to do is we're going to add a series to this bar chart by right-clicking. We're going to click on Edit Data. The Excel data source is going to pop up right here. And what we need to do is add a series. So we're going to add a series between B and C right here. So I'm going to right-click to insert a column. And we'll see if that pops up there. We'll insert that column, and then right here I'm going to type in negative 500, And then we will go ahead and just copy this all the way down. Negative 500 works. So you're gonna adjust your value here to what, however long your label is. Right now, I know that I only need to fit up to two digits. That's the number 1 through 10. So it can be a pretty small chunk here. So I'm gonna go ahead and close out of this. Now it defaults to that orange color. If I go ahead and click on no fill, that's going to, again, give us the plot area fill, which is that gradient. But instead of that, I'm going to go ahead and select the background color of my slide. So we're going to say solid fill, and you can see it already defaults when I click to solid fill to that the background of my slide. But if I wanted to make sure to do this, I would probably go to the eyedropper tool and then make sure it's, and just click anywhere in the background of my slide to give me that nice background. Now the series is still selected here. So with that series selected, if you unselected it, that's fine. Let's go back and select it so that you can get that little series of data, all those little squares, the negative 500 chunk. We're going to right click and we're going to add our data labels here. Now we don't want those 500s, right? Now what we could do is just click on each one of these and type in 1, 2, 3 down the list if we wanted to do that, or we could actually link this to our chart in some way. So what I'm going to do here, and I'm just showing you this so that you know this trick, with these data labels selected, go over to the bar chart icon right here, and you can see under label options, it says it's going to give me the value, which is, it's right now that's giving me the value that we put in those cells. But if I click on, if I unselect value and select value from cells, it's now going to open up the Excel file, and I could point my cursor anywhere to any sort of section of cells or any range of cells, and I could tell PowerPoint or Excel to give those data labels whatever I'm pointing to there. So I'm going to go ahead and just point to my rank column 1 through 10. I'm going to push OK. And you can see now that it's giving me those numbers. Now, of course, it actually did it in opposite because Excel is a little bit funny like this. Because remember the bar chart is actually opposite because Excel always gives us that opposite. Whatever you have, whatever order you have in your spreadsheet, it's gonna show up in opposite in the chart. So what we actually have to do is instead of 10 through 1, we just have to, or instead of 1 through 10 here on the sheet, we have to go 10 through 1. So I'm just gonna go 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And you can see it updates over here in the chart as well. Perfect. All right, nice. Let's go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and make these that Bandshrift font, semi-condensed. Let's go ahead and make these really big. Let's see. I bet there were like maybe 20. And I wonder if I do anything bold. Probably bold doesn't matter. Okay, so now I don't even need my my x-axis anymore. I'm going to go ahead and delete that. So just click it and backspace it. And right here, what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to use that paint bucket tool again to fill the color the color of my font of my label with the color of this bar. So right here, I'm just going to go ahead and we're going to go up to our paint bucket, and maybe even if you, or actually sorry, we're going to go up to the home tab and then the font menu right here. We're going to use this. Right now it's set to black, and you could probably, if you already had some of these colors saved, you could probably go ahead and do that from your current view menu. I wonder which one this could be. Maybe it's that one. And if you wanted to do the paint bucket, we could just go, or the eyedropper tool, we could do that. Eyedropper tool here, 3. Eyedropper tool for 4. And so it's another little tedious clicking game, but that's probably one of the easier ways that we're going to get these nice colors here. I'm going to make sure to get that perfect. You want to make sure to isolate them by double-clicking each label. That will isolate that one single label, and you won't make the change globally to all of the labels there. So that's one trick, one thing that you really want to make sure you do, because otherwise you're going to have to click a lot. So just make sure instead of all the labels selected, just the one single label is selected there. And we're going to go ahead and use that eyedropper tool one more time. Oops, where'd it go? Looks like it. I dropped picked up the color of my background of my slide there. Didn't want that to happen. Just a couple more here. Make sure that looks good. Eyedropper there. And let's see, one more eyedropper. And you can edit these how you like. Perfect. Now in the very end, we already had our labels, our bar labels right here. I'm going to go ahead and put those over, And I want to make sure that these are our semi-condensed. Very nice. All right, and I think that looks really nice. You've got a really pretty bar chart here with those beautiful gradient sort of rankings 1 through 10, those ranking labels, the city labels, the data labels for the median house or the median one-bedroom rents. I'm going to make sure to kind of nudge this one over. Let's use our arrow keys and just nudge this one over to do that. And then what I wanted to do, I have the example here, so we can actually bring this to the front. And we can see this one from the visual capitalist right here. You can also see that they did a few little annotations. So, excuse me, if you needed some text annotations there, all you need to do is just add a little text box. We could add a little text box right here pointing to New York being the highest rent. New York had the highest. Or whatever you wanted to, This is a great strategy, this annotation. This is a great strategy for, you know, anything that you want to draw your reader's attention to is really nice. I would probably make this a maybe a condensed, maybe not the bold, and probably just make sure that they're pretty small there. And then if you wanted to add maybe an icon, let's go ahead and go to the icons tab. Let's find a little arrow for us to use. Maybe a nice sort of thin arrow right here. That one looks pretty good. And I like that. You could just sort of size it and make sure that it's kind of the same color. So you can really see that once you get the bones of your infographic there, then you can kind of decorate it. And you can kind of add some of your own sort of personal little touches there that will make it a little bit easier for folks to understand the message of your data, the message that you're trying to share or show with the world. So I'm going to drag that off. Let's go ahead. That's the one that we made throughout all of our tutorials together. And then this was kind of the example that I didn't have the annotation there. So this was pretty cool. Steps 1 through 9. We had 1 through 9, 9 different lessons, kind of breaking this up on how to make a visual infographic right inside of PowerPoint. We made a really beautiful visual header. We worked with the Excel and PowerPoint's filled map tool to actually make a choropleth or a heat map like this. We made custom map pin icons and then inserted some text boxes. We created our own stacked bar chart with a really beautiful gradient fill background. And then we worked with some of the labeling and some little tricks, tips and tricks, some hacks behind the scenes to kind of get some custom labeling in there as well. So if you like this video and you like this mini series, I hope you'll give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a really great time making this for you. And again, let me know in comments if you like these kinds of sort of mini series or tutorials on how to make different things inside of PowerPoint. I love figuring things out inside of PowerPoint. You might be able to make some of this stuff in other platforms. A lot of people love things like Canva or Figma, or I know you use Illustrator and all that stuff, but I think that you can make a lot of this stuff right with the tool that you already have access to and you've probably used since second grade and you didn't even know it. So PowerPoint all the way. I can't wait to see y'all next time. Thanks again for watching.